public debt crisis underway must be primarily understood as a manifestation of the erosion of monetary and fiscal sovereignty caused by 30 years of free mobility of capital. In the era of inconvertible paper money, the sustainability of public debt did not pose problems which an unrestricted exercise of monetary and fiscal policy could not overcome. It is only when the free movement of capital restricts the means and deflects the goals of the policy makers that public debt, instead of being a tool to support the growth, becomes a powerful factor of subordination of the state to the lenders. The limits of the prevailing suggestions of how to deal with the debt crisis should therefore be highlighted in the first place by emphasizing that with complete current and capital account convertibility, it could be not possible to match the interest of the lender and of the nation as a whole. The most ambitious attempt to establish this correspondence has been offered by the theory of the expansionary fiscal contractions. Nevertheless, the relevance of the idea that fiscal contractions can combine the resumption of growth and the gradual debt reduction is limited, but it's unrealistic.